You may not have heard the name Henrietta Lacks, but she is an important figure in medical history. Evan Johnson from our sister station in Roanoke, Virginia, has the story of her legacy, one that will live on for generations to come.
Henrietta Lacks, a medical miracle, born in the Star City.
It's a great honor to know these things about my grandmother.
The married mother of five died in 1951 at 31 years old after a battle with cervical cancer. Doctors took samples of her tumor without her knowledge or permission and made a shocking discovery.
My grandmother's cells is immortal. They'll be around long when I'm gone, my great-great-great-grandchildren gone. Henrietta Lacks cells will still be here.
Lacks's immortal cells became known as HeLa cells and have been used in tens of thousands of medical studies, paving the way for advancements in HIV, in vitro fertilization, gene mapping, cloning, and cancer treatments. One of her greatest contributions, a vaccine for one of the world's deadliest diseases, polio. And those same cells are being used right now to fight the coronavirus pandemic.
I guarantee you that you benefit in some way from HeLa cells. Like, you know that wrinkle cream that you use on your face to get the wrinkles disappear? Henrietta, I mean HeLa cells.
Really?
Lipstick? Oh, yes. I mean, even her cells been in the space. They wanted to check what it would do to human cells.
Despite researchers relying heavily on HeLa cells, the identity of the woman behind them was unknown, including to her family, until decades after her death.
In 1973, when my mother uncovered the HeLa cells, she was having lunch with one of her friends and a professor came. And my mother's friend introduced her as Barbette Lacks. And the professor said, "We're working with someone named Henrietta Lacks' cells." And my mother said, "That's my mother-in-law." And that's when we first found out.
Up until several months ago, this space in downtown Roanoke was named after Confederate General Robert E. Lee. But now, the west end of this space is called Henrietta Lacks Plaza. You see that empty concrete slab right there? A statue of Lee once stood right there, but soon a statue of Lacks, a black woman, could be in that exact spot.
I think it's a wonderful thing, and I'm glad that we're able to recognize her.
Trish Whiteboyd, vice mayor for the city of Roanoke, is spearheading a project to raise $140,000 to build a life-size bronze statue of Henrietta Lacks.
I don't know if you know it or not, but she was just recognized by the World Health Organization. The WHO just put a statue in Bristol, UK, of Henrietta Lacks, honoring her. Certainly, we should have one in her birthplace, and that's here.
Whiteboyd is raising the money as a private citizen, but says the city is looking to bring a research team to Roanoke to shed some light on the stories of several local places and people hidden in plain sight, including that of Henrietta Lacks.
It's a wonderful story, a wonderful ending story about a black woman. You know, it wasn't a good story in the beginning because she was suffering from cervical cancer. But what she has done and her contribution to medical science is amazing.
Very proud.
To Ron Lacks, Henrietta is amazing simply because she's his grandmother. He says outside of her immortal cells, Lacks was no different from any other woman.
She loved looking elegant. She really did. That's why they talk about her painting the nails and the red lipstick.
She and her husband, David, were determined to better the lives of their children. That's why the couple moved to Baltimore, for better opportunities. All the while, the biggest opportunity for advancement was Henrietta herself.
Henrietta Lacks, to me, is my Nana. To the world, she represents the greatest gift to mankind.
In Roanoke, Evan Johnson, WFXR News.
Henrietta Lacks's cell line, HeLa, is considered among the most important scientific discoveries of the last century. And to see more stories honoring black history, you can go to the feature section of our website, foxsoonow.com. We'll be featuring other inspiring stories throughout February.